Hello everybody, welcome to today's episode of The Health Show. My name is Anshuta Singh and today's episode is going to be really special. Today we are going to be talking about a topic that needs to be spoken about a lot more, something that a lot of people need to know about. Yes, we are talking about emotional eating. Now I know a lot of questions arise in one's mind when we hear the term emotional eating. So for that we have with us today Mansi Sareen. She is a nutrition consultant and founder of Nutriyog. She is also helping clients to find freedom from food guilt and obsession and enjoy eating again from ground up. Now, without wasting any more time, let me please add Mansi to the stream. Hi, Mansi. How have you been?
Hi, Anshita. I'm good. How are you?
Very good. Very good. So, Mansi, for all the people watching you right now on Loofre.com, could you tell us a bit about yourself?
Yeah, sure. Thank you for allowing me to come here. So, I'm a nutrition consultant and founder of Nutriyog. We have clients all across the globe and I'm working with them through an online platform. So, basically, I am here today to deliver no-nonsense nutrition information and I make efforts to help people who struggle with their daily food choices. So I promote intuitive eating, which is honoring your body and just, you know, eat whatever you want to eat.
Yeah. Right. So Mansi, to begin with, could you first tell us what exactly is emotional eating about, you know?
So before talking about emotional eating, I would want to clear what normal eating is and what overeating is. So normal eating is, you know, eating when your body wants you to eat, when it's a physical hunger, jab aapko bhook lag rahi hai, jab aapko lag raha hai ki haan aapko bhook lag rahi hai. And overeating is eating to a point to the an extent of uncomfortable fullness. So let's come to emotional eating. So emotional eating is a method where you take food or you make food, you know, you use food as a response to your emotion. हम स्ट्रेस में हमने चलो घर आकर एक चिप्स का पैकेट खा लिया या यू नो यू आर स्ट्रेस्ड तो आपने एक चॉकलेट खा लिया या यू नो छोले भटूरे खा लिए तो ये जो हैबिट्स है हैबिट फॉर्मेशन है वो इमोशनल ईटिंग उसका बहुत बड़ा एक पैटर्न है जो हम जिसके बारे में हम बात नहीं करते हैं वी ऑलवेज टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डाइट्स कि ये डाइट कर लो वो डाइट कर लो बट वी नेवर टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इमोशनल ईटिंग इज सो देयर वाज अ स्टडी जिसमें बताया गया था कि one out of every five young Asian is suffering from emotional eating. And you know, we always talk about willpower, that willpower is important, motivation is important. But I think that to overcome emotional eating, to know the root cause of the emotion is very important. Because if you are eating emotion for the zabane ke kha rahe ho, to aapko pata hona chahiye aap kyun le rahe ho. Aap stressed mein ho, you're not happy, or you know, you are anxious. We are talking about mental health. So I think this is also very important to talk about.
Right, right. Also, Mansi, you know, there are a lot of sayings that, you know, emotional eating is this and that. But how would we differentiate emotional eating from intuitive eating? You know, what is the difference between the two? And what are the precautionary steps that one could take?
So basically, intuitive eating is to know कि आपकी बॉडी क्या सिग्नल्स दे रही है कि आपको कब भूख लग रही है इमोशनल ईटिंग इज इट इज नॉट द फिजिकल हंगर इंट्यूटिव ईटिंग इज द फिजिकल हंगर यू नो व्हेन यू आर इमोशनली व्हेन यू आर इमोशनल एंड यू आर ईटिंग तो एक देयर इज अ गिल्ट देयर इज अ शेम कि अच्छा आपने एक पर्टिकुलर फूड खा लिया क्योंकि यू नो वी अटैच मॉरल वैल्यूज टू द फूड इंट्यूटिव ईटिंग इज नॉट अबाउट अटैचिंग मॉरल वैल्यूज कि ये अच्छा नहीं है या वो अच्छा नहीं है यू नो वी कीप ऑन सेइंग डू नॉट ईट मैंगोज डू नॉट ईट राइस रात को ये मत खाओ 6 बजे के बाद मत खाओ इंटरमीडिएट फास्टिंग करो एंड डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ डाइट्स सो इन इंट्यूटिव ईटिंग देयर इज नो मॉरल वैल्यू अटैच्ड टू द फूड यू कैन ईट व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू ईट बट इन इमोशनल ईटिंग इफ यू आर ईटिंग अ पर्टिकुलर फूड फॉर एग्जांपल यू हैड अ बैग ऑफ चिप्स बट यू आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड your diet was you know it was not there in your diet so you'll feel guilty ki yaar aapne wo kha liya to aapke liye pura ban gaya
right
or emotional eating mein there is a negative feeling involved and also you're not hungry intuitive eating is when you're actually hungry तो उसके साइंस होते हैं कुछ, जो फिजिकल हंगर होता है और एक इमोशनल हंगर होता है, उन दोनों में एक डिफरेंशिएट आपको पता लग जाता है.
करेक्ट. Okay, so also Mansi, when we talk about emotional eating, so are there any stages in which that eating, you know, that tendency of emotional eating occurs? What are the stages in which one would categorize it?
So basically, there are three theories. So one is the escape theory. So basically, you do emotional eating because you want to overcome that negative feeling that you have. तो उसके लिए आप कुछ खाते हो कि चलो यार अगर आप रात को यू बोर्ड, सो दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस विद मी व्हेन आई एम बोर्ड, आई वुड वांट टू हैव समथिंग. तो वो एक इमोशन को ओवरकम करने के लिए आप कुछ खाते हो, दैट इज एन एस्केप थ्योरी. सेकंड इज द रिस्ट्रेंट थ्योरी. यू नो व्हेन वी आर फॉलोइंग अ पर्टिकुलर डाइट, वी रिस्ट्रिक्ट सर्टन फूड्स और सर्टन फूड ग्रुप्स, कि आपको आलू नहीं खाने हैं, यू डोंट वांट टू हैव राइस, आप ये नहीं खा सकते, वो नहीं खा सकते. एंड दिस इज आवर ह्यूमन नेचर कि आप जिस चीज को रिस्ट्रिक्ट करोगे आप उसी को ही खाओगे. तो एंड स्पेशली इन आवर कल्चर जहाँ पे यू नो वुमेन दे हैव दिस आइडल बॉडी इमेज कि उनको एक सर्टन फिटनेस गोल, यू नो दे नीड टू लुक अ सर्टन वे, तो वहां पे इमोशनल ईटिंग बिहेवियर्स बहुत ज्यादा देखे जाते हैं.
राइट.
एंड थर्ड स्ट्रेस थ्योरी. So, you know, it also happens ki whenever you are stressed, so there might be a condition jisme aap zyada khao agar aapko stress hai aur dusra banda kam khaye. So your appetite also changes according to the stress level. So that is the behavior stress theory. So these are the three stages, and you have to know ki aapka kaun sa stage hai. Aap kyun kha rahe ho? The strain theory ko aap le rahe ho ya escape theory, ya aapko stress hai to aap isliye kha rahe ho. So that is how we know kaun sa stage.
Right. So please help me understand this better. Like you said, you know, when you're bored, probably then you try eating a lot of things, you know. So how does one know or identify if they are into emotional eating or it's just a habit, you know, like I'm binge watching something and I have to have chips with me. So that's my thing. So how do we identify if it's actually become a habit or if it is emotional eating?
So basically, there are few signs that you need to see. First, there are negative feelings attached when you are emotionally eating. So अगर आपने कुछ particularly कुछ खाया है जो आपको पता है आप नहीं खाना था आपको, तो after you eat those foods, you will feel guilty or you will feel ashamed. So there are negative feelings attached to the food. अगर आप कुछ भी खाते हो तो आपको ऐसा लगता है कि आपने ये particular food खाया है, you will be ashamed. For example, आप डाइट में आज चावल नहीं थे और अगर आपने वो चावल खा लिए तो यू बी फीलिंग गिल्टी और आपको लगेगा कि आपने आज ज्यादा खा लिया है. तो नेगेटिव फीलिंग अटैच्ड होती है. देन यू नो व्हेन यू आर इमोशनली ईटिंग, यू आर नॉट एक्चुअली हंग्री, यू आर नॉट फिजिकली हंग्री. सो आफ्टर ईटिंग यू माइट फील सम यू नो ब्लोटिंग इश्यूज, सम एसिडिटी, तो देयर वुड बी सम स्टमक पेन, नॉजिया हो जाएगा किसी को. तो इनडायरेक्टली आप कैलोरी सरप्लस में आ रहे हो, eating more than you are burning. तो आप calorie surplus में आओगे तो आपका weight gain होगा ही होगा, ठीक है. So third is the unhealthy relationship with food. So when you restrict certain foods, you become anxious around those foods. तो एक unhealthy relationship आप food के साथ build कर देते हो. And the fourth point is that your natural hunger is disrupted. आपको पता नहीं चलेगा कि वो actual hunger है कि या वो emotional hunger है.
आपको पता नहीं चलेगा कि आप एक्चुअली हंग्री हो और इज इट जस्ट इमोशनल हंगर दैट यू आर फीलिंग. सो हाउ डू वी एक्चुअली गेट टू नो कि यू नो इफ आई एम एक्चुअली हंग्री एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम और नॉट, और यू नो आई एम जस्ट फीलिंग लाइक ईटिंग समथिंग बिकॉज आई एम इमोशनली हंग्री. सो हाउ डू वी डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन दीज टू?
So basically, physical hunger is the physiological need of your body and emotional hunger is the psychological need of your body. So when you're physically hungry, you don't want to have food right now. Aap wait kar sakte ho and there is no negative feelings attached. Whereas in emotional eating, negative feelings are attached and you want to eat something right away. And there is some particular food that you would want to eat. So agar aap when you are actually hungry, तो आप अगर खिचड़ी भी खाओगे दही के साथ तो आपका पेट भर जाएगा. बट देन व्हेन यू आर इमोशनली ईटिंग यू वुड वांट टू ईट अ पर्टिकुलर फूड, मे बी चॉकलेट, मे बी यू नो आलू पूरी फॉर दैट मैटर. तो आपको वही खा के आप यू आर सेटिस्फाइड. एंड फिजिकल हंगर में आपको एक्चुअली में भूख लग रही होती है, ठीक है, आपको पता लग जाता है कि यू आर फीलिंग हंग्री, देयर इज ग्रोलिंग स्टमक या एम्प्टी स्टमक. इन इमोशनल ईटिंग देयर आर मेनी थॉट्स अटैच्ड टू द फूड.
Right. So also, Mansi, help me understand that emotional eating, does this only come when you're feeling stressed or upset or have some, you know, negative thoughts within, or can it happen also when you're very happy or, you know, you have some happy thoughts just rushing in your blood veins? So is this only negative or can it has positive sides as well?
So it's a very good question. So basically, you know, certain foods are attached with certain emotions. Okay. And in our culture, you know, when there is a lot of social pressure, when you're getting married, you need to look a certain way, you need to lose weight, and we often make unrealistic goals. And when those goals are not achieved, we do the negative self-talks, and we demotivate ourselves, which therefore, you know, it is only helping in low self-esteem. To overcome those, I think what is important is, you know, instead of setting unrealistic goals, we need to see what our body can achieve. Hum kya kya kar sakte, because our body are meant to change. It cannot remain constant. Hum log 15 saal mein ye nahi kar sakte. 15 saal ki age mein hum log is time jo hamari, you know, lifestyle stress hum wo nahi le sakte hain. Or maybe when you're pregnant or the old age. So our body will constantly change, you know.
Correct.
So particular ek weight loss hai ki aapko 1200 calories pe khana hai ya you know to need to be 55 kgs. It's a myth. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Aap jaise jaise aap bade hoge, aapki your hormones are changed. So aapki body mein constantly changes aate rahenge. So agar aap 60 plus ke ho and you expect ki aap 50 ho jao, to wo thoda sa mushkil ho jata hai. And स्पेशली ये वुमेन में बहुत ज्यादा देखा जाता है, क्योंकि देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ सोशल प्रेशर अराउंड,
राइट?
या सो इन ऑर्डर टू डू दी नेगेटिव सेल्फ टॉक, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप ये देखो आपकी बॉडी क्या क्या कर सकती है, हाउ मच यू कैन, एंड यू नो यू शुड इंक्लूड फूड्स व्हिच आर न्यूट्रिशनली डेंस,
राइट? Okay, so what you're trying to say is, you know, it is very important to set realistic goals instead of just following the crowd and, you know, trying to fit in, you know. So also, if you could help me understand, you know, is there any certain food that is associated with emotional eating? You know, when we talk about emotional eating, can a person, you know, hop on anything that is available in front of them, you know, just to satisfy that emotional hunger? Or are there specific foods associated with this kind of hunger?
So there was a study which showed that certain foods which are high in fat and sugar, they can actually help in reducing the stress levels. But they're also addictive. So when we are eating those foods, we again and again crave for those foods. So there are basically four emotions involved in emotional eating. So first is fear, anger, tension and shame. So we call them fats. So you know, if you're craving for cheese, so maybe it's coming from an emotion where you want to heal yourself. If you're craving for chocolate, so maybe you are loved. If you are looking, if you want to eat some spicy foods, so maybe you are bored or you want to do something adventurous. So alag emotions alag alag khane ke saath jude hue hain. But then it keeps on changing also. It's not constant. So agar aapko, you know, during your monthly cycles, if you're craving one certain foods, you will not crave those foods in pregnancy. So it keeps on changing. So there's a book called Constant Cravings by Doreen Virtue. It's a very good book. So usne pura explain kiya hua ki kaun sa emotion kaun se khane ke saath juda hua hai. So yeah, emotions and, you know, food choices, they do matter.
Okay. Right. So this though, we've spoken about, you know, what emotional eating actually is and what food, you know, we usually associate with it. But are there any specific factors of food or lifestyle pattern, you know, that actually triggers that kind of, you know, emotional eating or, you know, binge eating, the tendency of that? Are there anything that actually help us trigger those kind of
yes,
things?
Yes, it does. So there are a few red flags that we need to see. So basically, agar aap ek diet se dusri diet pe hop kar rahe ho, you know,
right.
You're anxious around some foods ki, you know, you feel that maybe rice is not good for you, or maybe you cannot have that piece of chocolate, or you cannot have cake because it will make you good, it will make you fat.
Right.
Then, you know, assigning moral values to the food, ki ye clean eating hai, you know, the diet foods that we're getting in the market, and people were, you know, some people I know they're obsessed with their routines and they're so rigid with their routines and their, you know, exercise patterns. So I think flexibility is very important. Agar aap ek cheez aaj karo zaruri nahi hai, wo cheez aap kal bhi karo. And defining self-worth with how you look is not good. तो इन सब चीजों को हम देखकर ही बोल सकते हैं कि ये चीज आपको ट्रिगर करते हैं, क्योंकि अगर आप किसी चीज को रिस्ट्रेन कर रहे हो, किसी चीज को रिस्ट्रिक्ट कर रहे हो, ह्यूमन नेचर है कि आप उसके पास जाओगे ही जाओगे.
राइट. ओके, सो मानसी, इफ वी गो इन द टेक्निकलिटीज ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ हंगर दैट आवर बॉडी फील्स, so you know what are the kind of hormones that in our body, you know, that are associated with this emotional hunger? Could you tell us a bit about that?
So there are two hunger hormones. One is ghrelin and the other one is leptin. So basically ghrelin is called the hunger hormone, which actually stimulates your appetite and it increases right. your food intake. And leptin it lowers your food intake. It decreases your appetite. So the right. thinner you are, the less will be the leptin, and the, you know, if you're fat, the hormone will be more in your body.
Right.
So there are two hormones involved.
Okay. All right. So also, you know, how much of a role does water play in this entire thing? You know, is dehydration also, you know, a cause of feeling such a kind of hunger? Does it trigger it? Does it help it calm it down? What does the role, you know, of water is in this kind of hunger?
It is one of the most important nutrient in okay. our body. Our body is right. More than 60% water.
Correct.
So dehydration plays a very important role. If you're dehydrated, it's our body's natural way to tell us that you need foods, or you need more water, or you need more foods, water-rich foods like tomatoes, cucumbers, lettuce, celery. So if you are right. dehydrated, you will tend to eat more. So right. It's important to include 2 to 3 liters minimum of water during summer especially. And there are a lot of people who just cannot eat, just cannot drink water. So it's better to, you can infuse your water with fruits or mint leaves, or you can add herbal teas, but do not overdo it. There are also people who drink green tea for like 6 to 7 times and they think that they will lose weight. So it does not happen like that. You can right. include infused waters. But yes, water plays a very, very important
role. Right. Also, we've heard a lot, you know, that sleep patterns are, you know, one of the main reasons why a person feels a lot more hungry than they usually do. So, is emotional hunger also somehow associated with their sleep patterns? You know, a person who's probably sleep deprived and has not, you know, had a good sleep for a long time, can they also experience such kind of an hunger?
Yes, it happens with me. So I'm an emotional eater when I'm not right. sleeping properly. So it used to happen with my clients a lot. People who are into night shifts, they tend to eat more. Their food intake is higher than usual. And right. When you are not sleeping, your body's natural clock is disrupted. तो अगर आप सो गए नहीं तो आपको पता नहीं चलेगा कि आपको कब खाना है, कब क्या करना है. सो योर फूड इनटेक इज आल्सो अल्टर्ड अकॉर्डिंगली. योर एपेटाइट इंक्रीजेस एंड द टू हार्मोन्स दैट वी टॉक्ड अबाउट अर्लियर, ग्रेलिन एंड लेप्टिन, दे आर इंबैलेंस्ड. तो अगर ग्रेलिन ज्यादा होगा तो आपको भूख ज्यादा लगेगी. अगर आप सो गए नहीं सो इट इंक्रीजेस व्हेन यू आर नॉट स्लीपिंग प्रॉपरली. दी हार्मोन ग्रेलिन इट इंक्रीजेस एंड यू विल ईट मोर एंड दी लेप्टिन डिक्रीजेस. So when you eat more and you're burning less, you tend to gain weight. So sleeping 7 to 8 hours is important.
Right. Okay, so Mansi, if we talk about diet, you know, is there any special kind of diet that one can, you know, have to suppress this kind of craving or hunger?
So there are a lot of diets in the market, keto diet, GM diet, detox diet. So if your diet asks you, if your dietitian asks you to restrain or restrict a particular food group, then no. If you are restricting any kind of food or any particular food group, you will want to eat those foods more. So agar aap, for example, you're following a keto diet, or agar aap usme carbs aap hata dete ho, so aap, or agar jab aap carbs khaoge, you'll feel guilty. So that is correct. A sign of emotional eating. So agar aap us cheez ko kha hi nahi rahe ho aur aap uske baad khaoge, to you will feel guilty. So wo ek negative emotion aap food ke saath attach karo. So it's like unhealthy relationship with your food. Correct. I don't think any diet works. Jo ek, you know, it's a diet culture that we are living in. Alag alag diets hum kar rahe, you know, we hop on from one diet to another. So I don't think so any diet works. Choose what you think is good for you. So there are a few things that you can, choose from your availability, the kind of food that you like, or, you know, economic levels. Choices, your health, so all these things should be taken care of before deciding to, you know, follow any particular diet. And even if you are following a particular diet, just select the foods you want to eat.
Correct. So also, like you mentioned, that you feel the diet culture doesn't work. So what do you think is the main reason for it? You know, why does, you know, since there are a lot of different kinds of diet available that we know of, and also we are living in this diet culture. So what is the main reason you think it doesn't work?
So there is a concept called pseudo dieting, wherein you are not physically following a diet, but then you are thinking about diet. You have thoughts about dieting. So you attach moral values to the food. For example, agar aapne 3 mahine keto diet kiya and then you are off keto, and you get back to eating normal foods, which are high in carbs, like in North India. Roti, sabzi, you know, rice. तो आप एक moral value attach कर लेते हो उसके साथ, and कहीं ना कहीं आपके दिमाग में वो रहेगा कि आपको वो नहीं खाना है. For example, nowadays people are off dairy, off sugar, off carbs, and they think that it's a healthy living, a healthy lifestyle.
Absolutely.
तो कहीं ना कहीं आपके back of the mind वो चीज रहती है कि अगर आप इस diet को कर रहे हो या इस diet को कर रहे हो, तो you know. Especially in women, the ideal image that they have ki unko ek particular way lagna hai, to kahin na kahin wo dimag mein rehta hai ki agar aap ye khaoge to mote ho jaoge ya ye khaoge to mote ho jaoge. So I think medical conditions are very important. Agar aapko koi problem hai ya agar aapko koi disease hai, jaise agar aap gluten free kha rahe ho, tab kyun kha rahe ho gluten free? Agar aapko celiac disease hai to aap gluten free kha rahe ho, ya aapko gluten insensitivity hai, but agar aisa kuch bhi nahi hai, so I think it's absolutely okay to include all those foods, even sugar. So people, you know, there are some people who eat jaggery because they want to eat healthy and they're off sugar.
Right.
But agar aapko good se health benefits chahiye, to aapko bahut sari quantity mein khana padega.
Right.
Calories are similar. Agar aap good khao, agar aap, you know, you're having jaggery, honey, sugar, white sugar, brown sugar, coconut sugar, the calories are same.
Right.
You can choose anything, but yes, eating mindfully is very important. Ki aap kitni quantity mein kha rahe ho, kaise kha rahe ho, kab kha rahe ho, that is important. So that is something that you should work on. So that is why I do not believe in diet culture, because they do not work.
Right. So what would you suggest, you know, what should our relationship with our food or our lifestyle or our diet should be like?
Our diets should be, you know, when you're making food choices, you should always consider what you like, what you do not like. What is your routine? What are your health conditions? Where you are living? What is the availability? You know, your economic levels. Ki aap, you know, avocado hai. Agar aap usko le sakte ho, nahin le sakte ho. There are a lot of people you know, they want to eat potatoes every single day. And it's okay to eat potatoes every single day. And even then you can lose weight. So mindful eating is very important. Intuitive eating is very important. Agar aap kisi cheez ko karoge, to aap binge eating karoge, overeating hoegi. तो उसको कंट्रोल करना बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है.
Right. Okay, so Mansi, could you tell us about, you know, some of the questions that one should keep in their minds before actually hopping on something they like eating or something, you know? What are the questions that one needs to ask themselves in order to know if a food would work for them or not?
So basically, you know, if you like eating carbs and you want to go for keto, so you know it will not work for you. It's a short-term diet. तो आप उसको छोड़ने के बाद अगर दूसरी कुछ भी नॉर्मल ईटिंग पैटर्न पे आओगे तो आपका वेट बढ़ेगा. इट्स अ शॉर्ट टर्म मेथड ऑफ लूजिंग वेट. देयर आर लॉट ऑफ डिटॉक्स शेक्स अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. उससे आपका वेट तो बाद में कम हो जाएगा बट देन इट्स नॉट हेल्दी फॉर यू. यू विल रीगेन वेट आफ्टर अ वीक. तो व्हाट क्वेश्चंस यू कैन आस्क इज कि आप क्या खाना पसंद करते हो. व्हाट आर योर एक्चुअल फूड चॉइसेस. आप अगर कहीं जा रहे हो, यू नो एज ह्यूमंस we not only eat for our wellness, we also eat for emotional reasons, for, you know, social reasons. We want to go out with our families, with our friends, and we want to enjoy foods. So agar aap ek particular diet kar rahe ho, to you should always see ki aap isme bahar ja paoge, aapko kitna restrict ho loge aap. So these are the questions that you can ask, and also your health is very important. तो कितना न्यूट्रिशनली डेंस फूड है वो देखना बहुत जरूरी है. अगर आप राइस नहीं खा रहे हो तो आप उसकी जगह पे क्या इंक्लूड कर रहे हो कि वो राइस में जो न्यूट्रिशन है वो आपको प्रॉपर मिल रहा है. राइट. यू नो इफ यू आर हैविंग ग्रीन टी फॉर लाइक 6-7 टाइम्स तो उससे आपको क्या न्यूट्रिशन मिल रहा है कि आप इतना सारी ग्रीन टी ले रहे हो. इफ यू आर हैविंग यू नो फ्रूट जूसेस व्हाट न्यूट्रिशन यू आर गेटिंग आउट ऑफ इट. So these questions are very important.
So Mansi, could you tell us about some tips, you know, that would help us stop that binge eating routine or, you know, the hopping routine of ours? Some tips that would actually help us stop that.
See, first you need to know the root cause of your emotion. So if you're feeling, if you're, you know, if you're full, you're not too hungry, so you, and you are craving for any particular food, you could ask simple questions like, how do you feel? Like, are you happy around that food? Agar aap wo khaoge to, how will you feel? How will that food make you feel? And is it healthy? How much nutrition it is providing to you? And once you start seeing a pattern, you know, in some people, when they come back in the evening from work, they just want to hop on foods, you know, like chocolate, chips, और अगर आप रात को लेट तक काम कर रहे हो, यू वांट टू हैव मैगी. सो वंस यू स्टार्ट सीइंग अ पैटर्न, यू कैन एक्चुअली कंसल्ट अ काउंसलर जो आपको हेल्प कर सके. मे बी डाइटिशियन, मे बी अ थेरेपिस्ट हु कैन हेल्प यू थ्रू इट. सो फॉलोइंग अ डाइट इज नॉट एज इम्पॉर्टेंट एज क्योरिंग इमोशनल ईटिंग. सो इट्स नॉर्मल टू बी एन इमोशनल ईटर, एंड आई थिंक एवरीबॉडी इज एन इमोशनल ईटर. आई एम एन इमोशनल ईटर, एंड यू नो दिस इज अदर क्लाइंट्स इमोशनल ईटिंग पे. You know, they do not focus. Unko pata hi nahi ki ye bhi ek cheez hai, ye bhi ek, you know, we need to focus on emotional eating. Agar aap emotion ko dekh rahe ho ki acha, agar aap stressed ho, you're not feeling happy, aur agar aap wo cheez kha rahe ho, uske alawa aap kya kya kar sakte ho, what other things can you do? So writing down is very important. And jab aap pata lag jaye ki ye ek aapki habit ban chuki hai, you can actually consult someone who can help you through it.
Right. So could you also tell us, you know, some tips on how to eat mindfully? Like we discussed, it is one of the most important parts, you know, to understand what you're eating and be aware of the, you know, benefits it would provide you. So how does one do that?
So mindfulness is about acceptance, right? So what you can do is, first is eat slowly. So that really helps. And, you know, without any distractions, but I do not do it, so I do not even tell my clients to do it. So, you know, off phone, off TV. So that is also important. It plays a very important role, but it's okay. We can't do that. We can eat slowly. So, जो 32 bites का एक concept है ना, तो वो बहुत एक logical concept है. तो आप धीरे खाओगे तो आप कम खाओगे. Your appetite will not overeat. Second, it's a very powerful tool, and I also suggest my clients to follow it, and I myself follow it every single day. So just imagine that there's a, you know, emotional, there's a hunger and fullness scale. So from 1 to 10, so 1 is the it's the hunger level, extreme hunger level. 5 is neutral, and 10 is where you are full, you are comfortable. So right. when you are around 3 or 4, you would want to eat around 3 or 4, so that because when you come, like when you are when you reach 1 or 2, you will tend to overeat because you are very hungry. So you tend to over, and you need to stop when you reach around 6 to 7, so that you do not over consume, do not overeat. So this is a very important tool, and it also helps in sending our body that signal ki acha ab aapka pet bhar gaya. तो आपको जो फिजिकल हंगर और एक जो इमोशनल हंगर है उसके बीच में डिफरेंशिएट पता लग जाएगा. इट्स नॉट एन ओवरनाइट थिंग दैट यू कैन डू, बट यस, इट रियली हेल्प्स.
राइट. Okay, so this though we've learned the tips, you know, how one can understand the mindful eating, the concept of mindful eating. But also when we talk about diets and, you know, eating habits, one term that is often associated with it is body positivity. So could you tell the people watching you right now something about that?
There's a caption that I read somewhere that our body is an instrument and not an ornament. So, you know, we need to love and respect our body the way it is. So our body tends to change. Agar aap 15 ke ho, 30 ke ho, 40 ke ho, 50 ke ho, aapki body changes aane, you know, pregnancy weight, post-pregnancy weight, menstrual cycle, our body tends to change, old age. So acceptance is very important. It is all about accepting your body the way it is. Choose foods wisely, choose something that you enjoy. ऐसा नहीं है कि कोई डाइट चल रही है या कोई और डाइट कर रहा है तो उसको हम फॉलो कर रहे हैं. यू नो, प्रोग्रेस कैन बी डिफरेंट फॉर, प्रोग्रेस इज डिफरेंट फॉर एवरीवन. फॉर मी इट कैन बी टू कंट्रोल अ पीस ऑफ चॉकलेट, फॉर समवन एल्स इट कैन बी टू वर्कआउट 6 times a day. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ फोकसिंग ऑन वट यू कैन नॉट अचीव, इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू फोकस ऑन वट योर बॉडी कैन अचीव. सो पॉजिटिव बॉडी पॉजिटिविटी इज ऑल अबाउट एक्सेप्टिंग द वे यू लुक, एंड दैट्स परफेक्टली ओके. एंड इवन लूजिंग वेट, if you want to lose weight, that is also okay.
Right. So it's very important, like you said, to accept yourself the way you are. Of course, setting some targets that are achievable is always a good idea. But, you know, being in an unrealistic world and setting targets compared to somebody else's targets would just not work.
Yes.
So, Mansi, with this, we've come to the end of today's episode of The Health Show. I think it was absolutely fantastic talking to you. We all learned so much, and especially about emotional eating, because it is something that not a lot of people know about, you know, it's not very much spoken about. So it's very, very important to, you know, actually speak about it and let a lot of people know about it. So thank you once again. You've helped a lot of people who are actually struggling with this. And I would really like to thank you from our end. Any last thing that you would like to say to the people watching you right now?
Just accept that you are an emotional eater and it's okay. Everybody.
Right. And also that it's not a disease. So you don't have to fear it.
It is a problem, but then it can be solved. It's okay. That's absolutely fine.
Right. All right, Mansi. Thank you so much for being with us today. I think it was lovely having you here, and it was a very, very informative session. Thank you once again.
Thank you so much, Anshita. Thank you. I hope I added some value.
You did, definitely you did. Thank you so much.